So at week four is what we're doing right now is we're trying to understand how myeloma works or behaves in the patient. And one interesting thing that we've done is all the drugs that have been developed for multiple myeloma normally rely on regular lab tests and animal models, which are not the best way to represent what's happening with a patient and what's happening with the cancer in the patient. So we've devised this technique or method called Organoid, which is a three-dimensional model or culture where we take patients' bone marrow aspirate and we take some of their myeloma cells with all of the other cells that are found inside the bone marrow, and we mix them together and culture them and use a 3D printer to print miniature versions of these tumors and grow them in the lab. So now we have a bunch of replicas of a patient's tumor that we can then manipulate and play with and watch and see how what's happening. So why is this important? Why is this relevant? This is relevant for several things. One is we are actually seeing what the myeloma cell does with the cells that are normally around it and see how these cells are affecting the myeloma cells from developing resistance to chemotherapy or making them more susceptible to treatments or also helping them survive and live longer. Because we know that myeloma cells rely on all the other cells in the bone marrow so they can survive and develop resistance to chemotherapy. And then the other thing that we have been able to study with this is to test different chemotherapies and see which one of these chemotherapies has the best response in the cancer that's particular to that patient, which is a unique thing because right now when somebody has a relapse, there's 30 to even 40 different combinations and we don't know which one's the best one. And it's impossible to do a head-to-head study comparing all of these drugs because it would take the whole world to pitch in and agree on doing a study this big. And it's too many arms and it's just quite not possible. But by doing this in the lab, using your own tumor cells with your own bone marrow, then we can be able to compare different combinations and say, oh, this is the one that was more sensitive in your particular tumor. Let's try this in the future. Now, I can't say that we're at the point where we can start using the results of this study and treating patients with it, but that's our goal. And in order to get to that goal, we're gonna have to be practicing and testing many samples so that we can then validate that and say, okay, this is what we're seeing in the lab, and it is actually translating to what we're seeing with the patient. So we compare what the patient's therapy was when we took that sample and what they're gonna be getting. And we make sure that we include that therapy in one of the combinations that we test to see, okay, yes, this does correlate or this does not make sense. And the validation process is going to take some time, but once we do validate it, this could be groundbreaking and change completely how we manage myeloma. Imagine if you came to me and said, oh, and I had to tell you your disease is back, and we had to look at all the treatment options, and I had to just pick out of random one option versus me telling you, okay, let me do a sample, and I'll have an answer in a week and tell you which one's the best treatment for you. Which one would you choose? So I think that's the goal of this project, and so far we've been seeing very promising data that I expect to see in the near future it being applied in the clinic.